evening, everyone, and welcome to the annual BrassFest at the Music Academy of the West. We are very happy to have you here tonight. You're going to hear some wonderful music spanning 400 years tonight, played by some of the most talented brass and percussionists in the country. Now, for those of you that were here a little early, the Alpenhorn that you heard out in front was donated by the family of June Church, who is an avid supporter of the Academy, and in particular, the brass department. And we even found a Swiss to play it. When I told the fellows I'd like someone to play the Alpenhorn before the concert, Nicholas, who is from Bern, Switzerland, just jumped at the chance because he said he plays it all the time at home. So, thank you, Nicholas. Job well done. Thank you. So, our first piece, the Light Cavalry Overture, is Franz von Suppe's operetta Light Cavalry, which premiered in Vienna in 1866. Although the operetta is rarely performed or recorded, the overture is one of Suppe's most popular compositions and has achieved a quite distinct life of its own, divorced from the opera, of which it originally formed a part. Many orchestras around the world have the piece in their repertoire, and the main theme of the overture has been quoted numerous times by musicians, cartoons, and other media. You may not recognize the title, but you will surely recognize the music. This arrangement, by the way, was done by Academy fellow Matt Barker. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
That's a rousing way to start a concert, isn't it? The fugue in G minor, popularly known as the Little Fugue, is a piece of organ music written by Bach during his years at Arnstadt. It is one of Bach's best-known fugues and has been arranged for other voices, including an orchestral version by Leopold Stokowski. Early editors of Bach's work attached this title to it to distinguish it from the later Great Fantasia and Fugue in G minor, which is longer in duration. This arrangement for brass was done by Michael Allen.
Thank you.
Gabrielli's Canzone 15 is part of his 1615 collection. That's 400 years ago. And it's still good today. The main instruments used in this collection were cornets, violins, and trombones. This frequent balancing of cornet and trombone with violin shows how softly it was fashionable to play the cornet and the trombone around 1600. One surviving account praises a cornetist for being able to play in balance with a closed harpsichord. Nowadays, it is impossible to balance brass instruments with strings in these pieces, so one has to make a choice of either brass or strings. Most of the time, you will hear this music played on brass instruments. First of all, Gabrielli's music requires pointed, precise articulation to sound at its best, and brass instruments fulfill this requirement. In addition, brass instruments are well suited to the resonant type of acoustic for which this music was written. Just imagine that you are in the great St. Mark's in Venice and can hear the music resonate throughout the cathedral.
Thank you. Hello, hello. Check, check. Okay. How's everybody doing? Excellent. So, just to preface a little bit about the piece we're going to play. So, the beginning of the summer, we met, gosh, it was like the second or third day, and we just hit it off. We started reading a few chorales, and then we absolutely loved playing with each other so much. So we definitely thought, like, we have to play on some sort of concert, maybe a picnic concert, maybe we still will plan a picnic concert, but definitely like brass ensemble would have been a great showcase for us to play a really good piece in the trombone quartet repertoire, something that's challenging, something that's large in scope. So the piece we're gonna play for you is by a Dutch composer. Her name is Saskia Apon, and she originally started as a harpist, and she studied at the Rotterdam Conservatory. Believe it or not, this is not the first piece I've heard of where a harpist wrote something for trombones. It's been done before. And it's in two movements, and the first one is gorgeous melody, just absolutely flowing, and then the second one is a bit of a counting exercise, and you'll see why. So all of us, it's sort of more in a pointillistic style that all of us have our own eighth notes in each measure, and then it's supposed to line up and sound very much together in like one seamless eighth note line. This piece was written for members of the trombone section of the Rotterdam Philharmonic, and ever since it was composed, it's been one of the most popular pieces for trombone quartet in the repertoire. And it's been an absolute joy for us to prepare this, and we cannot wait to play this for you. So without further ado, this is Saskia Apon's first trombone quartet.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The Cabriole Suite was written by Peter Warlock. And Warlock was the pen name of Philip Arnold Hazeltine. Warlock never really settled into a conventional career. He did have some short-lived appointments, one as a music critic for the Daily Mail in London. His first major compositions, mainly songs, began to appear in 1917. It was at this time that he adopted the pseudonym Warlock, possibly in parody of his interest in the occult. The Cabriole Suite is a set of dances in the Renaissance style and is considered one of his most popular works. Originally written for piano duet, Warlock later scored it for both string and full orchestras. This wonderful arrangement for brass was done by Jay Lichtman.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back. We're going to move a little further in time now, closer to the 21st century. The composer's conception of labyrinth came out of a dream in which he saw himself standing before the gate of a giant labyrinth. It contained countless corridors through which he had to pass in order to successfully exit the maze. Each corridor had its own character, colors, and sounds, each very different from the others. The idea to transform this visual concept into an oral experience was the principle behind the piece. The traveler, the gate, each corridor, and even the labyrinth itself has a theme or motive of its own. Shortly after entering the mysterious maze, the listener is raced through a sequence of corridors, some dead ends, and some leading on to others, until after a small surprise, he bursts out the exit and into open, free sound, represented by the trumpet solo at the end of the piece.
Thank you. Thank you. much. So the next piece that we're gonna do is actually a brass sextet. Usually in smaller ensembles, you would see a lot of brass quintets. That's kind of our standard. But for this brass sextet, we're adding one trombone to kind of act as a bridge between our trombone and tuba even more. And the composer of this next piece is named Ingolf Dahl, and he was born in Germany, but he came over to the United States and eventually became a professor at USC. And briefly about the movements, the first movement is entitled Chorale Fantasy, Christ Lay in the Bonds of Death, and it's a very serious, very somber, very reverent movement. And you'll hear some Gregorian chant kind of things, but in a brass setting, which was actually around before our Gabrielli that you heard earlier in time. And then the second movement is very, very different, very contrasting, very happy, kind of like a hoedown. And then the third movement is a fugue, and it actually starts out in an odd meter, 5-4, and you can listen for it. Rainer, our second trumpet, actually starts, and then I go, and then, hey, even our tuba player gets the melody there. So without further ado, here is the sextet by Ingolf Dahl.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Actually, very quickly, before we begin the last piece, I would take a moment for all of us here to acknowledge our director, Mr. Lawrence, who has tirelessly put together this program for us, had all the patience to rehearse us, and be a great resource and a wealth of knowledge for all of us here for the last 5 weeks. So please,
before our last piece, I'd like to thank some people as well. Would any compeers in the audience mind standing so we could all see you? I just like to say, and I know I speak for everyone up here, we so much appreciate your service to the Academy and your dedication to the fellows. And they talk about it all the time. So thank you very much, very much. Our last piece is the music for the Royal Fireworks. It's a short piece. The music for the Royal Fireworks is a wind band suite composed by George Friedrich Handel in 1749 under contract of George II of Great Britain, for the fireworks in London's Green Park on April 27, 1749. And you'll get a kick out of this. This is the original scoring for the wind band. 24 oboes, 12 bassoons, and a contrabassoon, 9 natural trumpets, 9 natural horns, 3 pairs of kettle drums, and side drums. And remember this, this is 1749. On April 21st, over 12,000 people rushed to buy tickets for this concert, causing a three-hour traffic jam of carriages on the London Bridge. That's worse than the traffic on South 101 on a Sunday afternoon. And this wonderful arrangement for brass was done by Music Academy faculty member and former principal trombonist of the LA Philharmonic, Ralph Sauer.
Thank you.
You've been such a great audience. We have a very short encore. This needs